If you're ready to find your path to success or take the success you're enjoying to the next level, stay tuned. Successful Living with Bill Knapik is on right now.
Welcome to the show, Successful Living with Bill Knapik. That's me, and today, Successful Living with May She. MayShe.com. That's M-E-I-X-U, May built Chesapeake Bay Candle and is doing tremendous work. Now she has a new e-platform. May, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you for inviting me.
Well, we always like to talk with you so you can keep us up to date with all the exciting things you've done. And also, along the way, as you built Chesapeake Bay Candle, now you're creating this e-platform helping women with consumers, that you just have so many success things that you've incorporated into all your endeavors. So let's tell people a little bit about what you're doing right now.
Well, the idea really came when I stepped down from my previous company called Chesapeake Bay Candle. I ran the business for 26 years. I worked with some of the most successful and innovative retailers such as Amazon and Target. And while I have enjoyed the success, I always knew that along the way, I met many women who has great ideas, who wanted to start a business, and they could almost start a business, but at some point they stopped. They either don't have access to market, namely how to get into a retailer that will agree to try their product, or sometimes even when the product do get admitted into those stores, they don't know how to quickly ship them with the kind of volume that is needed. So after I stepped down, I enjoyed a little bit of thinking time. And while I think involved in educational activities to help those women is very helpful, it is not a long-term solution. I think what they really need is a platform that gives them the kind of access collectively to American consumers, and also supporting them with logistics, know-how, sourcing capabilities so that they can focus on what they do the best, which is be the creative and innovative business owner that bring great products that consumers have been looking for.
In fact, I remember your interview as you talked about Chesapeake Bay Candles, and when you were building that business, persistence is so important, and we work so hard from the sales and marketing aspect in many of our endeavors, as we work very hard there, and then someone says, yes, can you deliver, and have, they may want to place a huge order. You have to also be ready to make that delivery too, sometimes in short order.
Absolutely. I remember one of the stories that I always tell is how I started working with Target after having worked to gain some volume experiences with customers such as Bloomingdale's. But you know that when you work with Target, the volume is very different than with a Bloomingdale. And in one shot, I have to ship 10 containers, 20 containers of 40-foot size. And, you know, that's the kind of scale that all of a sudden you have to deal with. And we're talking about within a 3 to 4 month period of time. So many women, business owners would have a few issues when that happens. Number one, they would be jumping up and down with joy, but then they would say, how?
Now
you know,
what?
I don't have the space. I don't have the labor. I don't even understand how you deliver to a giant like Target, which has automated menu receiving and require specific labels to be put on every package so that it's a machine that's going to scan all these packages and distribute them to different stores in the country. So just understanding the whole supply chain and comply so you don't get delays is a tremendous knowledge base and capability. And that's where many women business potentially can fail and then never have a chance again to go back to their retailer.
Well, you said something earlier I think that's very important. That is, you're talking about you had some thinking time. So I want to see if you can give us a word about that thinking time. Do you have that in terms of, is that organized or things come to you and you write that down? And then the other thing I would like you to point out too, the power of an idea. Sometimes ideas come upon us and we can act upon them, follow through, and things like that. But give us an idea of your thinking time and how you get these ideas. And then it is exciting to see an idea harvest and be something that is very powerful for us and something we enjoy and others enjoy.
Absolutely. I used to have a very structured thinking time because I was working really hard with my team. When I was working at Chesapeake Bay Candle, I have a pretty large creative team. And as you know, the creative types, after a while, can hit what we would call really a stumbling block. They stopped being creative. They started to be really short of ideas. So we decided each week on a Friday, we will have a blue sky thinking time where I don't want to talk about any project that we are ongoing, but something they like, either it's a painting or it's a new movie, it's a Netflix film, that they think that give them some interesting thought about anything. It could be a new way of communication, a new music style. Clearly, something relates to our work will be a lifestyle trend, how people talk about health, how people think about health and wellness, or just a new fragrance, a new name for a fragrance, a new color of lipsticks. Anything goes. And that is something that I sort of systematically implemented to encourage a lot of blue sky thinking. So after I stepped down, where I don't have a team anymore, I still try to give myself some blue sky thinking time. As you know, it's harder when you are working by yourself with a much smaller group. I have three people working with me, mostly on some of the nonprofit side that I'm helping, as well as some of the board engagement. I'm on a few boards, including the board of University of Maryland, Baltimore, and on an investment board with an incubator called Halcyon Fund in D.C. So with some of those work, I have a small staff, but it's not the same to have a dedicated time. So what I try to do is on a daily basis when I do my yoga afterwards, that's where I have a little bit of time, maybe 30 minutes where I scan some news, and that's where I really allow myself to do a lot of thinking. Rather than getting quickly to my emails, I give myself about, 30 minutes to jot down new ideas that is around the world. I don't get news just from the U.S. As you know, I read Chinese and some French, so I get news from around the world.
We are talking with Mei Shi, meixu.com, and that is M-E-I-X-U. Go to her website. It's incredible. And Mei, you beat me to the punch, because I was just about to ask, as far as success, being physically fit and engaging ourselves in physical activities are so important. And that's a lot of places where I get my ideas when I'm walking the dogs and doing my exercise. When I get back, I write those ideas down. Sounds like you do too.
Absolutely. And one of the things that really started to clarify for me what I want to do is, like everyone else, I started probably stopped going to retail stores maybe for the last 5 years. And it's just being about online shopping. While online shopping has come a long way, if you want products that are known, such as your papers, papers for printing, your shampoos or soaps, it's very easy. Amazon has done a great job. I have to really, commend them for the speed to consumers and the way that you can almost rely on them versus, sometimes they deliver within 2 days, sometimes not. While you can get a lot of things from Amazon, it's not enjoyable. I go there, I get my work, I get my orders in, I know how much I paid. It's not a experience that I say, oh my, I'm going to be on Amazon. Let me get myself a glass of wine because that's such a great experience. Or let me do it at the most enjoyable leisure. It's something you do as an errand, where I remember those days when I was younger and the store's a lot more exciting. You really use it as your sort of fun time, right? Remember those days where we window shopped because we really like to see what's out there? Or you engage with a store owner because he or she is an incredible source of new ideas and they are the first to introduce something. Those days are gone, and I miss that. Second thing is I also constantly are asked to give speeches or presentations or on a panel to discuss how I build my business. And many times women come to me and say, how do you know it's the right moment to start a business? Or how do you know this is the right idea to launch? And after I answer all these questions, I thought that maybe I should start a blog to introduce many of the women who have the same question and who have the same struggle, who does not like to work for a 9-to-5 job who have passion beyond what they're doing. And how did they get over the anxiety and started a business and are happy about that? So I started introducing every week a new women entrepreneur on Meishi.com. And now I have so many people coming to me to share their story. I can line up to the end of this year who I can feature. And they are from every kind of business you can imagine. Some are very successful. Some are just startups. But the one thing they share in common is they abandoned what's known, and they decided to seek the unknown because it's rewarding and it allows them to pursue their passion. So in the end, idea was born is that not only am I going to showcase what they do from the writing, I'm actually going to allow them to sell their product. And in doing so, I built an access for them to consumers. American consumers are very innovative. They are one of the most daring type because they are very rewarding in the sense of taking risk. And I think if we can succeed here, then we can succeed anywhere.
Well, let's tell people also, as we think about different levels of success and different times when someone starts a business or begins an idea, most often there are always challenges. Some challenges are tough to overcome. Some are just knock you down. But let's tell people your mindset, even as you built Chesapeake Bay Candle, what you're doing right now. I know you're determined, persistent, and all those things, but give us an idea and help people with the mindset that you've used to get you through the challenges in everyday life and everyday business.
One of the things that I think really supported what I do is that I have always been very global-minded, and that applies to when I started making the product, Chesapeake Bay Candle. I knew that the kind of product I will make, it's not going to be easy for United States. And rather than feeling disappointed or, you know, feeling discouraged, it doesn't take me long to think, you know, I came from a country where manufacturing has just started in the 1980s, and it's a great manufacturing base to tap into. Now, no one has ever smelled a fragrant candle in China. No one have ever made one there. But it never stops me, right? To me, it's all about maybe being the first to try something that doesn't make a lot of sense, but if you believe that there's a market, if you believe the financials add up, that's something I'm very good at, is I do a lot of analysis financially to see what's the labor cost, what's the transportation cost. Does it make sense to bring fragrant oils to China and then put them in the candles so that I can obtain really good quality and still able to tap into the labor force? So these are things that obviously sound very complicated, and I understand it's very challenging. That's exactly why I want to solve some of those mysteries with the Meishi.com platform. So women will have someone to tell them, this is a no. Don't go to France to make perfume shampoos to be sold in the United States. Why? The shipping cost is going to kill you. Instead, you could develop your fragrance in France or with a French-based company, and you can bring the fragrances here so that making a shampoo, which 80% of the time is really liquid water, can be done here. So there's many different ways to solve a problem, number one. And having a problem doesn't stop you as long as it's a great idea. I think you started with the idea, like you said, and you need to also test the idea. I'm never a believer that experts will tell you it's a good idea. I believe the market will tell you if it's a good idea or not, because the power is in the consumer. If they vote you in, you're in. No matter how much the experts think it's not doable, I never listened to most of experts when I grow up because of that. No one would think that you can make fragrance candles in 1992 or 94, I'm sorry, and you can bring it all the way here because it doesn't make sense. But a lot of things doesn't make sense. I don't think Elon Musk makes sense when he said he wants to make an electric car that would cost over $60,000-$70,000. And he succeeded, and people love that. So best ideas sometimes look ridiculous for that reason. If it's been so easy to be accepted, everyone would have ideas that flies. So I think to be confident to use the market and consumers or your customer to test that idea, and then be open-minded about where and how you get it done.
That is very interesting. And it also, as we are doing building businesses and having ideas, what you're now presenting is another tool for people to accelerate their growth by having this forum where people can where you can help them, maybe perhaps a shortcut or two. So simply people can go to mayxu.com as that develops, M-E-I-X-U. The other thing, May, that is very important in all aspects of business, especially with realtors. I talk to a lot of realtors and involved in a real estate show as well. But as far as branding, everybody thinks about branding in different ways. In your years at Chesapeake Bay Candle and what you're doing now, your name is very easy to remember, May She. Right there is a tremendous brand. But give us a word or two about branding.
I think branding has gotten really a little bit more intense in the last decade with the rise of social influencers. The brand that used to be about product or a big company has increasingly shifted to individuals. So in other words, we are all our own brand, right? In that case, I think it's power to the individuals, but it's also very risky. So I personally feel that the most important thing about a brand is to be authentic. It's probably overstated, but I don't think it's really enough to emphasize that the integrity and the uniqueness of a brand is by far the most important asset we can protect, and we can really invest in. Many times there are brands that are, you know, a copy of another brand, because if it's a Burger King, maybe we can call it a Burger Queen, for example. And I always laugh at that to say, you know, why do you want to be a me too? Why do you want to be a second of anything? You want to be the best of something. Create that category and own it rather than follow other people's steps. That's probably what I mean by authenticity and being confident that if you deliver consistency and authenticity and you have something unique, focus on that. And that to me is the most important essence of brand. Obviously, there are different ways to promote your brand. There's all kind of social media. We're talking about Instagram plus YouTube too, the rise of TikTok, where very short videos are available now for influencers. You can always ride on these waves of platform. But one thing never changed is that people want to see the real you. People want to see the brand. Who owns that brand, what they stand for, that's what is the most important.
That's right. When we have something we like, a product, a service, it is interesting to see the people behind the scenes, what they do, and even their everyday lives. I think many of us, human nature is that we are curious. Some are more curious than others. And May, let's say with the last 5 minutes or so with the show, 3-5 minutes, what else would you like people to know about what you're doing or anything else?
I'm very excited about launching this website. I am at the phase now, which is really just start putting some word out there that we are celebrating women businesses, particularly women businesses in consumer area. We're not yet in the phase of launching e-commerce. We are in the process. The kind of categories I'm interested are fashion for women. We are very interested in cosmetics and skincare, wellness products, infant and baby care. We also want to really focus on home decor, because as you know, these are categories that I feel some of the biggest retailers really left a lot of room for desire, because they're not really focused on trend and consumer insight. That's the kind of thing that I'm very focused on, and I hope to partner with businesses that are interested in growing in this area. And I think that's how small independent brands can compete, and that's where I'm very excited. So they can reach out to me, and not only can we highlight their business, but we can start thinking how we can help them to sell product on our site.
And if someone wants to reach out to you, what's the best thing to do?
They should reach out to info@mayxu.com.
And that's M-E-I-X-U. I love your name. I love your brand.
Yes.
You know I'm a big fan. So,
well, it's very easy to pronounce, unlike what people think. It's actually one of the easiest names, probably the shortest names. And I hope that you appreciate that it sounds like Mei Xu, and then we say, yes, Yes, she may. She may. She may succeed. She may get to her dream, and she may grow her business. Another thing I want to just ask for help. I'm very honest. This is a new community. We are starting out. So if you have any, ideas of what kind of website you'd like to see women build for themselves, as we know, most of the e-commerce websites are built by men for men. So I would love to hear from you. Any ideas that can help our community grow, it would be great. And we will have women business owners in other countries one at a time, because I want to build infrastructures one country at a time. And it's my goal that we can help lift a lot of women from poverty and provide for their family and their children the kind of path to success that we enjoy in this country. And that's what we can do for each other.
And May, if there's a young lady that might be listening to this show, or someone that reached out to you, if you were to tell them just one or two things of encouragement, let's say the young lady's a teenager, knowing what you know now, what would you tell that young lady?
I think they're living in a terrific time where anything is possible, but don't settle for mediocre. Settle for the sky, for the top, because they can do that.
There you go. MayShe.com. May, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you, Bill, for your patience, and I love to visit, particularly when it's nice and balmy and warm.
It is that right here in Houston. You're listening to Successful Living, MayShe, MayShe.com. Thank you so much. Thank you, May.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Houston. Bye-bye.
Bye. And go to RadioBill.net for more information, and MayShe.com, M-E-I-X-U, and we'll see you next week.